His musical debut album is coming out soon. His dad was a pro boxer, folks. It's Drew, the mighty Matador Whitley. A self-employed 27-year-old from Ashley Down, Will the Raging Bull Justin! Ladies and gents, fighting out of the black corner, hoping to make some sweet music tonight, it's Drew, the mighty Matador Whitley. Hello, the red corner, hoping to do his team justice, it's Will, the Raging Bull Justin. Three rounds each after two minutes. Over to Tony.
So fight number nine then features Drew Whitley, who, it must be said, looks the part, doesn't he? Came in with a gown on and everything, looks like a boxer, and his dad was one, apparently.
And we watched him train, didn't we? And he looked the part in the gym as well. Now he's going to prove that when it matters, he can still look the part.
Yeah, and up against him is Will, the Raging Bull, Justin.
Round one.
And Will has a little bit more stature about him.
Is that what you call it?
I'm trying to be polite. But let's see what he can do as a boxer. He's moving around a bit for a big boy, is Will. And again, as we've seen before, physical presence can have a big effect, and the adrenaline is rushing around both of them here. It will hopefully calm down after about 30 seconds when they've finally decided that they're going to relax into it. And already that first flurry has died down just a bit. Certainly Drew can box, he's got the attributes to do it, got long arms, long reach. So as the tactics are going to be interesting to see if Will Justin can get inside and land some shots. But at the moment it's Whitley moving well and lands a good right hand there, feints with the left and the overhand right comes in, that was blocked, carried away by the left arm of Justin there. But already the speed of Whitley is causing Will Justin some problems. And he's having to think defensively most of the time. Jab, 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 says somebody in the crowd. That's always good advice to whoever it's aimed at. What Justin has to do is to try and get inside and cause some damage, but the speed of Whitley and his long reach, that jab just keeps flashing out into the face of his opponent. Looking very comfortable in the ring as if he belongs there. Lands a good right again, does Whitley, but back comes Justin. And a good effort by both boxers, but as I say, Wedlake certainly looks like he knows his way around the ring.
Whoever it was shouting jab, jab, jab was surely shouting it to Wedlake, because if he boxes behind his jab, he's got such a long reach that the other guy's just not going to get to him. Justin's got to try and crowd him and use his weight, if you like, and push him against the ropes, which we've seen earlier effectively this evening. But he's got his work cut out here, because this lad probably looks the most accomplished boxer we've seen.
Yeah, absolutely. So coming up to the second round then. This is the ninth contest of the night, 11 in all. Drew Wedlake, he has a charity single out, it's called Rise Up. And he's donating all the funds for that and of his efforts tonight to the Brandon Trust.
Seconds out.
There's a trickle of blood from the nose of Will Justin. Shows that
round two.
That Wedlake has been getting through in that first round. What can he do in the second? And this again is Justin trying to force his man against the ropes and land some shots in the early stages. And again, just sheer physical presence forces Wedlake back. But I think it'll settle down as the round goes on again, probably go back into the same pattern as the first. The long reach, the long jab of Wedlake. But fair play to Justin, he's cutting the ring down and forcing Wedlake onto the inside where his long reach is negated. Wedlake again getting the space between the two and lands a good right hand, and then another one follows up. And this time it's the opponent actually complaining he was caught around the back of the head. He goes down claiming that he was hit on the back of the head. Didn't really see that happen, did you, Rich?
No, I certainly didn't see it, but whether he's buying a bit of time here or not, I'm not sure. He's not happy. That's for sure. He's having a go at the referee and his opponent.
Yeah, I don't think there was anything deliberate in that by any means. I think he might just have got caught as he turned away, possibly. I don't know. But clearly, Will Justin not happy. Wedlake carrying on with the boxing. And the Raging Bull has definitely got the rage at the moment. Pushing his man back, and it's become a bit of a roughhouse over there in the neutral corner. Referee calls another break, just tells him not to be quite so ragged. Wedlake comes in behind that right hand. Bit swinging though, losing his style now. Should be boxing, not doing those big haymaker swings. And he's falling into that trap that so many do.
Wedlake has been drawn into the sort of fight his opponent wants, and not the fight he should be fighting.
No, get behind the jab, keep it long. Box, he's got a bit of class about him as Drew Wedlake. And at the end of the second round, certainly Will Justin had a better round there than in the first, but I would still say that Wedlake is the better boxer, the classier boxer. And I don't really think there was anything untoward. I'm sure Justin must have got clipped on the head guard, but I don't think it was anything deliberate by any means.
No, I certainly didn't see anything deliberate. And I think Wedlake's got this fight to win. It's in his own hands. If he fights the fight he should be fighting, he'll win. If he gets drawn into a brawl, he could go the other way.
So Will Justin clearly not happy with what happened in that round, but he needs to clear that from his mind and just get on with the job in hand. He's gone now.
10 seconds. Seconds out. Third and final round.
So here we go with the third round between these two. Drew Wedlake in the black. The pop singer against Will Raging Bull. Self-employed man from Ashley Down, just 27 years of age. Wedlake doesn't need to get into a brawl, but at the moment he's been trapped in that corner. And Wedlake now, this time boxing his way through to his opponent. Referee breaks him up once again. Wedlake, get behind the jab, just box and move. Jab, jab, and then follow up with the right hand, which he does. Falling short a couple of times there with the jab. He's still got such a reach advantage, and then Justin just bundles him up against the ropes and tries to land on the inside. So it's a brawl now, and Wedlake needs to get it at a distance again. And the referee calls a break, coming towards the end of the contest. Again, Wedlake needs to box a move, not get trapped in on the inside, and Justin holds on. Again, Wedlake's back to his boxing again, trying to jab and move and then throw the right hand. Become a bit of a wrestling match on this, in this neutral corner. Wedlake lands a big right hand, but back comes Justin, roughing him up in the corner. And I think the bell must have gone there. I didn't hear it, but the bell's gone. And that was a big effort by both boys.
Yeah, fair play to Justin. I thought, having seen Drew Wedlake in the gym, he was one of the big favourites tonight. He was given all the trouble he could handle there without any question. He may still have just nicked it, but it was a closer fight than I think we thought.
Certainly was, so let's wait and see what the official verdict is.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, a huge round of applause for both boxers in that contest. And the three rounds, ladies and gentlemen, your winner. Please a round of applause for Will Justin!